Okay, my people, I know that you've been doing these crazy home workouts. We just finished Jordy, so I am recording a 30-minute stretch for you to alleviate any kind of aches and pains you might have from working out on all these odd surfaces, from going out on the streets and running. Don't go for 5-mile runs. Walk, sprint, mix it up. Don't try to do these feats of strength when your body's not ready for it. So the stretch is ideal to keep your body limber and injury free. We do balance moves, we do really intense stretches. I want you to grab a towel, a belt, anything you have. A lot of you don't have rings, so we improvise. Grab something so that you can use that as a little leverage. We're going to start off with one balance move, and I always tell you that a balanced body is an injury-free body. So let's start off facing one side, knee is underneath the hip. You're going to drop, your back is flat, your butt is contracted, your heel takes the support, not the ball of the foot. You're going to float that right toe up to the knee and then bring it down. You're not going to kick out, so it's up and down, up and down. You have to breathe as you do this. You have to hold your abs tight and open your chest. Drop deep, but don't overdo it. Six. Now we're going to hold the toe to the knee and try to create balance. And breathe. Inhaling through the nose, exhaling through the mouth. Try to plank this leg like it's a tabletop. Relax the foot and straddle out. Inhale through the nose. Deep breath, palms touch, let your arms just drop out. Exhale. Now let's turn on this side. Your knee is underneath your hip. Your heel takes the support. Your back is open. Your abdominals are tight. We're going to lift the knee. Here we go. One. Two, remembering to stop the toe at the level of the knee. You don't want to go higher because it just compromises the hip flexors, the spine, to stay balanced. And continue breathing on your drop out. Squeeze the glutes. Keep it controlled. Keep focused. And we need this stretch in this very stressful time that we're in, my friends. Hold up. Jordy just gave us such a workout. We're a little wobbly. A little wobbly in the butt and the legs. Thank you, Jordan Brown.
You're welcome.
And Liz is going to give you some health tips.
Sure.
Maybe at the end of this video. Straddle out. Take a deep breath. Inhale. Stretch long. Drop this right arm down. Do not drop the chin. Keep the feet about shoulders width apart. Chin is off the chest. Inhale, exhale. We're going to draw the elbow up in the air to the opposite side. And exhale, but your feet are still planted. Your hips do not move. Inhale through the nose. Expand your rib cage. Fill your lungs with air and then exhale calmly. And up again. Let's reach. Take it to the other side. And over. Now this feels really good after doing all that weight work. And I'm sure you're doing following all the amazing fitness incentive instructors through yoga, Pilates, dance, weights. We have, everyone has stepped up and I could cry the community that we have. We're really, really blessed, my friends. Stretch up. Now this one more. Drop the right arm. Take this, or the left arm. You're on the left, actually. And try to reach behind. Without overdoing it, you don't have to grab hold. The key is not to drop the chin to grab hold. Chest proud. Inhale, exhale. Marianne Jedrilinic, I hope you enjoy this. And all my stretch followers, miss you so much. up, and let's switch sides. This arm drops, the opposite arm reaches. Don't grab hold if it's too much. So you want to keep the chin off the chest, something like this if you can, or this is fine, or use your towel if you need to. Squeeze your gluteals, rotate your inner thighs in, learn how to lift your pelvic floor. That's the muscle between your pubic bone and tailbone. Once you learn how to lift it, it gives your body balance. Let's take it down. Let's take it over, folding to the side. Drop gently. We're going to open our legs, lower our arms out in front. Open our legs until you just feel it in your inner thigh and groin. Please do not overdo it, especially if you're on the tile floor. Your legs just slip out too far. You don't want to overdo stretching. You want to feel it and breathe through it. So when you feel tight, if you take a deep breath and inhale through your nose and calmly exhale through the mouth, relaxing the neck and shoulders, allowing the forehead to draw to the floor. Lift your navel to the spine. Now before you come back up, your palms are underneath the shoulders. Transition, knees together. Shift it back and arms out in front, like you're gripping into whatever surface you're on. Grip in and draw back, elongating the spine, opening up the vertebrae. Now, pressure and stress and life and gravity compresses our entire spine. And we have to find ways to elongate it and open it. Opening the vertebrae is so important. So inhale through the nose and exhale through the mouth, relaxing the neck and shoulders, letting your body almost melt to the floor. Place your palms underneath the shoulders, round your spine up, and bring it over slowly and gently using the abdominals. Now, I incorporate a lot of active movement, a lot to encourage blood flow. And that's so important because when you're in these folded positions, it creates constriction. So blood flow is so important, and always encouraging blood flow toward the heart is key. So we're going to roll back gently. And we're going to go double right, double left, double right. So using your fingers in an interlocked way, starting from your ankle, rolling up your shins to your knee, again, encouraging that blood flow to the heart. So this really opens up hip flexors. Feels so good and encourages that blood flow, again, toward the heart. Now hold. Charlotte, I hope you enjoy this stretch. I know you've been waiting for this. Flex and point. Relax the neck and shoulders. Turn your head to the left or right and turn to the opposite direction. Flex and point with your feet. We're going to place the left foot on the floor or the right foot, whatever leg you're on is fine. Unfurl this leg so it comes right over your face. Don't lock the knee. So this is where you, before we use our towel or a ring or whatever we have, we're going to encourage that blood flow toward the heart. And massage, find the split in your gastrocnemius, that's your calf muscle, with all your fingers. Use your thumbs on your shins. This encouragement of blood flow to the heart is what helps prevent spider veins, varicose veins. We have to do this on a regular basis. So right here, you're going to decide, can I grab hold with my hands? Do I need a towel, a ring, anything, a belt? It doesn't mean you're anything less than anyone else, my friends. Stay at your own level. We don't all have the same level of flexibility. So grab hold if you can, or use your towel exactly like my little models. So you're going to draw this heel up toward the ceiling, elongating the leg but never locking the knee. Holding the abdominals tight and keeping both legs in line with the spine. Inhaling through the nose. Exhaling through your mouth. So feel wherever you're tight through this leg. Focus in on that area and breathe calmly. That's what will eventually open up those tight areas, but you have to remain calm. Don't use your neck and shoulders, and make sure that you breathe clean breaths throughout. Taking this entire top leg and wrapping it over the bottom leg, getting your heel to approach that ankle. Before you lift the legs, I want you to super engage the abs, relax the neck and shoulders, draw both knees up so that your knees are right over your sternum, your shins are even and parallel to the ceiling, your abdominals are super tight. You're going to put your arms out in second position. That top leg is going to draw. So my right leg is over my left, therefore I'm going to drop to the left. You pay attention to what side you're on, okay? We're going to lower the legs without creating a dropout. Slowly, slowly, slowly. Exhale as you do so. So let me tell you the importance of this stretch. Mainly, it really opens up our lower vertebrae, especially L4, L5, where a lot of you have issues in your lower back. This really helps open up. It decompresses. If you feel a little pop, it's a beautiful thing. You're not hurting yourself. It's that compressed vertebrae actually unsubluxating, meaning it releases, it decompresses. Place your opposite hand on that glute or hip. Slide that leg away, relax the neck and shoulders. Let your feet just melt. Don't grip with the feet. What happens is when you're tight, you feel tension. The neck and shoulders get involved, the feet get involved, and they should not be involved in this stretch to open up your lower back. So staying right here in this position, elongating this opposite arm over the head, getting the bicep right next to the ear, but don't allow the hand to touch the floor. Reach really long, draw the navel to the spine. Take a deep breath, inhale, exhale. Now we're going to reach the same hand overhead. We're going to do an active movement for the shoulder, the delts, the traps. Reach and pull. And active movements are critical, especially we're doing this weight work, we're doing all these crazy things, just to keep that blood flow going, keep the flexibility, and help avoid injury. Now with the heel of this hand, and please, and I always tell my students, do not be embarrassed. I know little Mary and Ellen are cracking up right now, but take the heel of the hand and massage your lymph nodes that are located on the right outside of your pectorals. Please don't be embarrassed, because lymphatic drainage is so important, and strong studies in all medical journals have shown that lymphatic drainage is important to help prevent breast cancer. So massage away and give it good pressure. Like I tell my students, you're fully clothed, don't be embarrassed. Or maybe you're not clothed, I don't really know right now.
That's a view.
Okay, arm out. And the same way you lowered your legs, holding the abdominals super tight, you're going to bring it up slowly. You're going to cross this ankle over the quad and press the knee away. With the heel of both hands, you have lymph nodes located between your pecs and your sternum. Up and down motion, and give it really good pressure. Holding the abdominals tight. What's going on back there?
Johnny's gonna be like, what's gonna be like?
Are you behaving?
Yes.
Yes. Arms out. Now just rock and roll this knee. Again, back to that active movement to encourage blood flow, especially through the inner thigh and groin, where we do, if you have a seated job or you do a lot of constricting work, This helps open it up. Hold away. So now we're going to address glutes and hamstrings, which tend to be ignored by many people. You're going to grab hold behind the leg that the foot's on the floor. So make sure you grab hold that foot on the floor at the hamstring, draw in, open up, circle that floating foot. Relax the neck and shoulders and reverse your circle. Now this next one is glutes and hamstrings, and again, Jourdan Brown, Alardi, Jourdan Brown Alardi, gave us some pretty intense glute and hamstring work today, so we're going to address that. Foot right over the face, let go, and this is where you decide what level of flexibility you have. This is fine if you want to use your towel or your hands, but it's not done like this. You know I tell you this all the time. You do this, you're not doing yourself a service. Just grab hold, bend the knee, so that that knee pushes that right calf to hover right over your sternum without compromising blood flow and airflow. You're not crushing into your body. Your navel is firm to the spine. You inhale through the nose. Now, remember, if this feels too intense, you should feel it in your glutes and hamstrings, but some of us feel it in our knee. And it generally means that you're just overdoing your quad work and you don't have enough balance in your routine. If that's the case, cut back a little bit, don't lock the knee, and then return. You're not going to hurt yourself. It's just something you should think about, how you're training. Let's come out of this gently, feet over your face, grabbing hold wherever you feel it, flex and point. So what I want you to do is take the abdominal wall and lower it to the spine. And then in turn, try to take the spine, especially your lower back, toward the floor. Now let's hold it. Use your towel, whatever you want. Bend the knees to the chin, extend the heels up. Bend the knees to the chin, extend the heels up. And bend, and extend, and bend, and hold that extension up, and breathe. Try to keep the feet, knees, and thighs together. Try to, and you know I tell you this all the time, you do proper stretching. It burns just as many calories as doing everything else. This is tough, it's tough work.
Yes,
but if you adhere to it, it just gets easier and easier, and it's just amazing. It's a game changer, my friends. Grab hold behind the quads and just let your feet bop. Feels so good. Like you're walking right and left, right and left, right and left. So we're going to repeat the process. Bring your feet down gently. Relax the neck and shoulders. Now, you can, before we go to the opposite leg, your body settled down. You can grab hold at the back of your sneakers or at your ankles. I want you to feel like you're peeling your spine off the floor, starting from the tailbone up to the upper vertebrae. But do it slowly and gently, almost like you're peeling a piece of tape off the floor. Slowly rise. Chin stays off the chest. Zoop really wants to be in this video. We might have to have him do a little guest appearance at the end. So keep the chin off the chest. Lift, keep the knees about shoulders width apart. Puff your chest out, inhale through the nose. This feels so good, doesn't it, girls?
Yes.
So the same way you went up, you come down slowly. We're just going to address the lymph nodes on the inner thighs before we go to the other leg. Bring the heels together, not the feet, just the heels. Let your legs drop out. Squeeze the heels in and press the abdominal wall down so that the small of the back actually tries to connect to the carpet. Using your fists, Massage your lymph nodes located between the inner thigh and groin. And don't get silly on me, people. Just do it. Bring the legs in. Bringing the opposite leg that you didn't work over your head now. And massage, flex and point. Sorry, I usually give all my students a little bit of the Axel Wellness CBD cream. Lavender oil, and there's a candle burning, but we can't share that with you right now. So next time, or before you start this, light a candle. Use your products. You know, Dina Boyd always says, use your lavender oil. She calms her dogs down all the time with lavender oil. It's hysterical. So we're going to grab hold wherever we feel it and draw back, right? Keeping the neck and shoulders relaxed, keeping your abdominals firm. Inhale through the nose. Exhaling through the mouth. Beautiful. Now try to draw your heel a little higher. Relax. Let's cross this entire top leg over the bottom leg. I'm so happy to be able to give this to you, friends. Get the ankle and heel to just about meet. Before you lift the legs, it's so important that you draw the navel to the spine and hold your abs tight. Draw her up until your knees are over your sternum. Your shins are parallel to the ceiling and the pad of both feet are relaxed. Arms out in second position. Lowering that top leg to the opposite side without creating a dropout. It's done with control. Exhale as you do so. Exhale. This is such an important stretch because again, I'll tell you, we hold a lot of tension in our lower back. Take a deep breath, inhale. Oh, I just felt a little pop. It's such a beautiful thing. It feels amazing. We might not be able to see our chiropractors, our massage therapists, Dr. Don Brown, you know, she can answer questions on the phone, but we can't see all the professionals that we see. So we have to improvise, my friends. Take that top arm. Place it on your glutes and slide that leg away. Remember, the spa store is still open. You can order products. We can deliver them right to your house or ship them to you. So if you need shampoo, conditioner, supplements, any kind of Eminence face products, please advise us. We'll get that to you. Or even if you need a nice candle, we'll get it to your house. Can't do anything about the hair, so you're going to have to start hiding the gray and the color that comes through. We'll be fine. We're all in it. We're all going to look funky together. Inhaling through the nose and drawing the knees up using your abdominals slowly. Cross the ankle over the quad. Now rock and roll this knee in and out. We already got this lymph node, so we're going right to this movement. And this is that active movement, encouraging blood flow through the hip flexors, through the groin. So try to give it a good rotation. The more you rotate, the more blood flow. So we're going to press it away. Holding the abdominal wall tight, relaxing the neck and shoulders. Yes, it's 11-11.
Jourdan just told me that's my lucky number, my friend.
Liz told me. It's a chain.
It is a chain. Grabbing hold behind the quads, draw the legs in. Do you know that my boss, Catherine George, that I had when I worked in Manhattan, still sends me messages when she sees 111 or 1111. So I guess it stems from way back. Way back. Draw it in, relax the neck and shoulders, let the feet relax. Floating foot rotates. And reverse it. Kathy Peacock, Kelsey Peacock, I hope you're doing this stretch. Bring this right foot over your face, grabbing hold wherever you feel it. We're almost to the end. Stay with us. Look at my models. They're beautiful.
Can't see your faces.
So, use your towel or whatever you choose to have and bend this knee so that the calf lowers toward the sternum. But never, remember, it does not crush into the sternum, does not stop circulation. You always want to keep that good blood flow and that air flow so that the stretch becomes beneficial. Inhaling through the nose. Exhale, draw this heel up and away. Without locking the knee, without creating tension. And bend again, and this one's going to be a little longer. Just hold it. So you should feel this again in your glutes and hamstrings right here. If you do feel it in your knee, you're not going to hurt yourself. What you'll do is just cut back and it'll alleviate it and you'll bend again. But it is a sign that you're overdoing quad work. You don't have enough balance in what you're doing. You need to do a little more glutes and hamstrings, inner, outer thighs. Let's come out of this gently, feet over your face, flex and point. Inhale, exhale. Let's hold the flex. Try to keep your toes in line with your eyes. Now, let me stress this. If you can't do this, and that's perfectly fine, you're going to put one foot down so that you're able to keep this foot right over the face. And bend both knees and extend it up. And bend both knees and extend it up. And on the extension, you never lock the knees and the lower back draws to the floor. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. And exhale, draw up. Do this with your kids. I know that everyone feels cooped up, but this is such a great family thing to do. It really does calm you. Bring it down slowly, slowly, slowly. So this one, grabbing hold of the ankles, feet are shoulders width apart. We're going to draw both legs to whatever side you choose. That bottom leg is going to be out to the side and the top leg is going to be in line with the spine. And I'll tell you what the stretch does, and it's an amazing stretch. So you're going to lower slowly, take this hand that was holding the ankle and reach over your head. So you have this one leg down, out to the side, and then this other leg that's right in line with the spine. And what you're going to do is, if you feel good in the stretch, so let me turn a little bit so maybe you could see what I'm trying to express here. You're going to feel as if someone's got you by this leg that's pointing in line with the spine, and almost like they're pulling it out of the socket. So This stretch is so important because it really gets the iliotibial band. That's the long muscle that runs from the hip through the outer thigh into the knee. When that muscle is tight, it really translates to hip and knee discomfort, and it's usually a tight iliotibial band. It gets your outer thigh, your tensor fascia lata, gets your gluteus minimus medius. It gets your psoas. The psoas is a very deep muscle that lies between the pubic bone, the hip bone, and the spine. And that muscle is what gives stability to our upper body and lower body. When that muscle is tight, and Google it, it starts with a P, psoas, you'll learn how to palpate it. And if you feel discomfort in your psoas, you have a tight psoas, and generally you might have hip discomfort, and it's just a tight muscle. So this stretch will really address that. It's an amazing stretch. So if you have flexibility, you can bring this heel a little closer to your glute without overdoing it. Reach both arms over your head and stretch long. Don't let the hands touch the floor. Almost as if someone has you by the hands, pulling your hands out and away from the body, pulling your knee out and away from the body. And let's bring it up to neutral slowly, and we're going to rock side to side just to get that blood flow going again. We're going to do the other leg. I'm going to have you come up to a standing position, and we'll be at the end of our stretch, my friends.
Okay.
Sleepy time. Okay, so same concept. Lower the legs to the opposite side. If you can get your outer thigh to touch the floor, that's wonderful. If not, be respectful of your level. You're going to draw this hip up toward the ceiling, and it's almost as if someone had you by that leg, pulling your leg out and away from your body. You're going to slightly puff your chest out, take a deep breath, inhale through the nose. Exhaling through the mouth. Calmly, Jourdan Brown Malardi. I heard.
That was Liz. No.
So right here from the same position, and once you know where your psoas is, you can palpate it. I don't want you just palpating without even knowing where it's located. Arms over your head, reach long like someone's got you by the arms, pulling your arms long, chin is off the chest. Take a deep breath, relax the pad of both feet, inhale through the nose, exhaling through the mouth, and another inhaling through the nose, and exhaling through the mouth. Bring it up very slowly, slowly, slowly. Now, you know I always have you rise in the safest way for your spine. So you're going to use your elbows, your hands, and your abs. Press your body weight up. Flip your knees to one side and take it up to all fours. Take a deep breath, inhale. Head comes up, tailbone rises. And exhale. Draw it all in. And again, inhale. And exhale. Let's take this right foot in between both hands. Let's come up to a tripod, making sure the back heel touches the floor. Your body's just going to drape over this leg in front. You're going to wrap your forearm around your calf and draw your entire body weight down, creating a oneness between the body and the leg. Beautiful. Shoulders relaxed. Palms down. Feet together. Switch sides. Switch legs. Sing it. Sing it, girls. Wrap it around. Draw it down. Create balance. Hold your abs tight. So we're going to turn forward. We're going to bring the heels in on the inside portion of the knee joint. Now we hold a tremendous amount of tension in our inner thigh, groin, and neck and shoulders. And this really addresses the inner thigh and groin. Bring your palms together, place the elbows on the inner thighs. Right your body. And breathe. Relax the neck and shoulders. Bring it up, toes forward. Now using upward strokes on the legs. This is probably my students' favorite part when you bring that blood flow up. Little tapotement, little stimulus for those muscles. I hear Charlotte. Inhale, exhale. Head is last to rise. You have to bring your head up last because you can get quite lightheaded from coming down position up. Inhale through the nose. Palms touch. Stretch along. Go mid-range and let your arms slap down. Inhale again. Deep breath. Stand tall. Mid-range. Slap down. And last one. This one we're just going to drop out from the very top. Inhale, exhale. And I thank you, my friends. I love you. We're just going to bring Zook in because he's desperate for an appearance. Jourdan's going to go get him. Thank you.
Thank you for joining. Zook!
Come, Zookie! Come here, baby. Say hi to everybody.
You're wondering why you weren't in the video, right? Or giving kisses?
Oh, you want weights? You want weights? He's so excited. He was outside the whole time.
Oh, he's
stinky. You know, we have to have a Zook appearance.
He's a wet dog.
Love you guys.